I love changing the chord with my bass note, with my note. And that's another thing, you gotta know the chord when you do it. So I call it the fake out. I'll change my note and the people will look at the dude on keys and be like, woo, and they don't know it was actually me that changed. But I love that. I love that aspect of that. I love how random church is. Church is random. Some old church mother gonna get up and start singing a song in E. I mean, it's gonna be all kind of stuff. You know, there are keys that certain people play in that's more comfortable, but church is anything goes. It's any tempo, it's any key, anything goes. So I love that because it keeps you on your toes. It keeps you knowing how to improvise. It helps you in that aspect a whole lot. And just the places you can take, the service, you know, just being more than a musician, you a minstrel, you can help lead the people in the worship. You can lead them to so many places. I just love that. I love being a part of people being blessed and people, you know, you see demons being cast out and you see all this stuff and like you're playing and you're actually a part of that. I love that. I love that part.
I've had the opportunities of, you know, playing, you know, different styles of music. I've played with pop artists, I've played with R&B artists, and my roots are playing in church, playing gospel music. The one thing about gospel music is it's a melting pot. It's a melting pot of so many different genres and so many different styles. So it's kind of like a boot camp for, you know, musicians, you know, because you have to be able to retain music. You have to be able to learn quick. You have to be able to adapt to different styles. You have to be able to flow in a service. You have to be able to be keen of what's going on around you. You have to know what to play, what not to play. There isn't necessarily a book on this is how you play in a church setting. For me, it's made me sensitive to my environment. Say music is healing. You know, there's healing in music. Even outside of gospel music, if someone is going through something, they'll listen to a love song that'll probably give, you know, uplift their spirits. If whatever the emotion that they're feeling, there's a song for it, you know. And in church, it's a song of healing. It's a song of hope. It's a song of deliverance. It's a song of the miraculous. And for me, it's a little deeper because of my own personal testimony. So because of my personal testimony of healing and watching how God has moved in my life, and as a musician in church, it's I play from a different place. I play from my heart. I play from a place of worship. So in being in church, it allows me to do that. It allows me to be free. It doesn't allow, and when I say free, I don't mean I can just play whatever I want to play and just kind of be all over the place. There's still order. I'm still playing in a band setting, but I'm playing with like-minded people. And our first goal is to glorify God and to usher in the presence of God. And in that, there's unity there. And things happen. Lives change in that type of atmosphere. And for me, personally for me, it's prepared me for so many different situations, musical situations, genres outside of gospel music, outside of the church. It's prepared me to adapt to where I am, to be an asset to where I am, to make sure that I'm playing my part and I'm playing with everybody else, and that there's a camaraderie, there's a sense of fellowship there. There's a sense of hope there, that the music, that whatever we're playing, it's drawing out emotion to whomever the audience is. And but church will always be my number one love, gospel will always be number one, just because of what it means, sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. And then I have my own personal testimony, so it'll always be something that's deep to me.